A11, A12, A13, all the way to A1M. That's the first row of my matrix. And then since it's upper triangular, I have a 0 all the way below A11. But A22 might not be 0. A23, here's A2M. So that's the second row. In the third row, I have 0, 0, A33, all the way to A3N. And the very last row only has ANN, that might not be 0. So that's kind of a picture of the matrix. And so then there's two things going on. We're given, if I call this matrix A, we're given that A is an orthogonal matrix. That means two things, right? It means that the columns are unit vectors. If you dot them with themselves, you get 1. And it means if you dot them with each other, you get 0. And then we need to show, we're trying to show A is upper triangular. No, we're trying to show, it's given it's upper triangular, we're trying to show it's diagonal. So one way to say that is Aij equals 0 if I does not equal j. That's maybe a quick way to say it. So maybe another thing to do to do this proof would be this. Let's write that matrix A is also this. V1, V2, it's a bunch of columns. There's n columns. And then ask yourself, for instance, what is V1 dot V2? Yeah, that's 0. Right. But for V1 dot, and these are vectors, right? When you do V1 dot V2, which... Oh, thank you. We're going to do a dot product. Thanks. That's a scalar. When you do V1 dot V2, what you're really doing is V1 transpose times V2. We talked about that before, but that's how you'll do it, say, in MATLAB or something like that. When you transpose that and make it a row, and so what's it equal? Well, it equals A11... A12, right? So those are going to get multiplied together. Plus, well, 0 plus 0, right? Everything else is a bunch of zeros. So like you said, Marla, that's the number 0. 0 equals A11 times A12. And those are numbers. So what does that mean? It means either A11 equals 0 or A12 equals 0. But then what?
It
has to be this one, right? We know this is non-zero. Otherwise, you couldn't have a unit vector. And then, basically, you just repeat that argument as often as you need to. So if you repeat the above argument .vj to show that aij equals 0. And again, for I not equal to j. And that's kind of it.
You just keep doing that. And there's nothing special about the numbers 1 and 2.
You put in any two numbers in that order.